What up, YouTube?
So, you might be wondering why I'm standing here in front of a block that's been torn down. Well, it's because I took it apart. And I did have it on video.
I did, yeah. But I fucking deleted it, so my bad.
I was making the iMovie and I needed to make some space to save it to my phone, so I deleted the videos thinking they'd stay on iMovie, and well, they didn't. So, I'm gonna give you all a little recap of what went down. Basically, I got everything pulled out, a little bit of wear on the bearings, a little bit hard to see, but the center bearing main looks pretty good, but they all look pretty worn. And I found all this sludge in the motor. I contribute that to it sitting for a year. Sat for a year before I got it, so moisture, the cold temps, up and down fluctuation will cause that to happen. So I don't think it's anything major I have to worry about, but I mean, we'll see what happens. New bearings and rings. Gotta measure, mic out the crank. As soon as I get my telescoping gauges, we can mic out the mains with the bearings in them, then mic out the crank and we can find our clearance. And gap our rings, throw it all back together. But today we're going to clean the block. I have some brake clean and some degreaser. It's not really too dirty, it's kind of hard to see, but most of that is grime that I'm going to be using the degreaser for. So it's not huge cleanup, but definitely make it look 1,000 times better. Later, probably next week or later this week, we're going to be taking the head to the machine shop. First, I'm going to disassemble it, take out the rockers and the rocker rod, take the valves and springs out, the valve stem seals, and everything that they could possibly lose. I know they may not, but that's just me. I'm going to take everything out just so I can keep it here. And send that out to machine shop to get cleaned, hot tanked. I was thinking maybe, depending on the surface of the head, because I haven't even looked at the surface, just the head gasket. Maybe a couple thou off of the head just to clean it up, but I think that it may not need that. So as soon as I get the head gasket off, and as soon as I start tearing that apart, then I'll know for sure. But it's definitely gonna get hot tanked, get it cleaned, get it brand new and ready for the process. Another thing to note before I start cleaning this thing, I thought it was pretty dope, to be honest. The block still has crosshatching on it. Now, I don't know the mileage. I don't know the mileage of the block. I don't know if you see the crosshatch. But still having a crosshatch is good news. Now, once I get this all cleaned up, I will be wiping the cylinders and the mains and the bottom end basically down with oil so that there is no rust, and I will also be covering it with a trash bag to keep moisture out of it, to keep it all nice and fresh and not rusty, because it's not what we need. But let's get started. Guys, so check it out. I was literally just taking off a hose and I peeked down here and I see the socket, and I'm like, what socket is that? I didn't lose a socket, right? The fucking 10 mil, dog. It's the lost 10 mil. Yo, you're looking for a 10 mil, I got you. Ha. Someone's lost 10 mil. Found it.
Well, with the engine out in the sun now, we can see the grime. It's pretty dark, pretty caked. I'm gonna hit it with some brake clean and throw the degreaser on it and let it eat it up and see how clean it gets. I might throw a coat of paint on it. I'm not sure. I'm gonna do like maybe like a wrinkle black, like a VHT, if it'll handle that, or I don't know, maybe just the soaper, but I'm thinking about it. Let's see how she cleans up.
So it says for the gunk to let it soak in for about 10 to 15 minutes. And while that time, I am going to clean some other parts I brought out as well. Windage tray, oil pickup, and the oil pan, since the pan had a lot of gunk in it. I'm gonna be cleaning that up and freshening them up so they're obviously nice and clean and ready for rebuild. So just from visual inspection, you can see the gunk that was in this engine. I could have let this go. I could have not opened the engine and just tried to run it, and this stuff still would have been in there. So it's I'm glad I'm taking it apart. That's all I got to say. Can brake clean. Go to town. Set them all up on this piece of wood to try and keep off the grass, keep it dirt from getting to it. I still may get these parts cleaned, hot tanks at the machine shop. See what it'll cost. I want to keep the cost kind of relatively cheap, but then again, I want to do it the right way. So, you know, if I can get these clean enough with just a little bit of brake clean, maybe a scrub brush, I'll be happy. They don't have to be sparkling pristine. They'll work though. You have this material. I can't remember exactly what it is, but I used it to clean the valves in my B16 whenever I rebuild that. I'm gonna see if it'll help take off any of this varnish. Let's see. I mean, yeah. All right, so looks like I'm gonna hit this a couple times with some brake clean and see how well I can get this kind of scrubbed up and clean. Catch you on the flip. So this is the bottom half. Actually cleaned up pretty well. I mean, there, I could keep scrubbing on this stuff, trying to get that off. But it's pretty clean. Inside cleaned up real nice. Look, don't these guys look so happy to be cleaned? This one was shocked, but he's like, I'm so nervous and confused. But yeah, anyways, cleaned up. Now I'm gonna move on to clean up the pickup, and then we'll get to that stuff. Just gave the oil pickup a little scrubbing. Now we're gonna hit it with some brake clean. See what she looks like. She looks just about brand new. Now onto this oil pan. This is going to suck. Let's see. That's not really gonna come up. I'm not gonna scrub it, but that stuff is thick, dude. Thick. You know what? I might just have to break down and get this thing power washed. I mean, hot tanked. That stuff doesn't want to come off, and I don't feel like wiping it with my material and getting it all fucked. So. Maybe some degreaser will work. Let's see. Put some degreaser on it. Let it sit for 10, 15 minutes. See how this looks after that. Melt away! So it's been about 15 minutes or so. Spray the block down and see if she looks any bit. Nope.
So it honestly doesn't look like that degreaser did much of anything. I mean, there is some gone, but it's not really done much. I am going to hit it with some brake clean and this pad and see what we can do. Try to get this thing a little cleaner. Well, this, I mean, it kind of worked. It took off a lot of the grime, but it's not as clean as I want it to be. So I'm actually going to take everything off of the block and take it to the machine shop and have them hot tank it so it can be basically zero dirt. Got you. But yeah, so we will pick up after this comes back from the shop. Well, I just dropped off the block, mains, oil pan, valve cover, cam caps, windage tray, stuff like that, off of the machine shop for cleaning. So the next clip you guys see should be getting the engine mic.